Praise God. Shalom, shalom. My name is Charlie G. Thank you very much for tuning in to today's broadcast. I hope and I do believe that you're going to be blessed. And so we are doing a series of identity, in that each and every one of us, when we know of identity, when we know of who God has called us to be, in that we should stop living a life of being and just simply just be who God has called us to be. And so today we're going to look at the virtue of our walk with Jesus. Our walk with the Lord Jesus Christ is very important, in that if we are to be fully assured, fully aware of identity, then our walk with Him is very important. Our Lord Jesus Christ, when He was calling the disciples, He told them, "Come and follow me and I will make you fishers of men. Come and follow me and I will make you fishers of men." In that, sometimes people usually think that the life of Christianity is a life of loss. That's a life from the pit of hell. That the life of Christianity is a life of more. It's a life of, it's like an adventure. It's like an adventure of a discovery. Of a discovery of who you are in God, who you are meant to be in the society, who you are meant to be in the world, who you are meant to be. That's the beautiful thing about our life in salvation, our walk with the Lord Jesus Christ. It's a life of identity, the life of adventure, in that who you are, in that the way you thought of yourself last year, in that the way you, in that as you continue on living a life in Christianity with the Lord Jesus Christ, walking with Him, in that we continue on having our identity being refined in the standards of the world, being refined in the standards of the world. But you as in identity in God, in that it's sealed already. You're a child of God, you're a heir of His kingdom, you're His beloved, in that that's constant. But now in relationship to the things of the world, in maybe last year they call you this year a higher standard, this year in that it keeps on getting better and better. It keeps on getting better and better because of your walk with Him. And that let it be, I think, for each and every one of us, in that the promotion that you're getting is because people are like, in that it's like we did not see this in you. It's like we don't see this in you. In that the more you continue on walking with the Lord Jesus Christ, the more this thing continue on being made aware to those of whom are around us. In that last year they thought lowly of us, this year they are thinking of a particular area of us, next year they'll be like, in that you become a wonder to them, That's the same thing about us with God, in that the way you knew God yesterday is not how you know Him today. In that there's more in God, That's the same thing to each and every one of us, in that we got to see of the way Abraham, in that he walked with God, and then when he was being tested, in that then his name was changed from Abraham to Abraham, which means father of faith, father of all nation, father of all faith. But for each and every one of us, you see, as Moses, Abraham was like in a journey, and then he went and they defeated, rescued the Lord from there, from those of whom had captured him, and then the Lord appeared to him, telling him that I am your shield and your exceeding great reward. I am your shield and exceeding great reward. In that God continue on reveal Himself to him more and more. And so it's for each and every one of us, in the pass the test. And that as believers, we not be tempted. As believers, we cannot be tested. We cannot be tempted by God, but we can be tested by God. And when God tests you, it's because He wants you to realize of something about yourself. He wants you to realize in that you are more. He wants you to realize that now you've been there for too long. Now move on to another position. Now move on to another area. Now move on to another thing. So let us pray. Almighty, never leave you, Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm grateful for yet another opportunity, another privilege you've given unto me to share your word, oh God, with your loved ones, oh God. And dearly, Father, may I speak your word, oh God. May I speak word, dear Lord God, that shall liberate each and every one of us, oh God. And this is the Spirit of God. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's liberty, oh God. And dearly, Father, I speak liberty, oh God, because your Spirit is here with us. We are gathered in your nation from being in the midst of them, oh God. Dearly, Father, I know. And I do believe, oh God, there shall be an uplifting, oh God. There shall be a breakthrough, a breakthrough, oh God, a break free in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Let your be sitting in our hearts and be a fruit in our life. And this I pray, that we pray in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen, amen, amen. And so to each and every one of us, is the question of this: how is your walk with God? Do you read your Bible? Do you have time to pray? Do you have time to fellowship with the believer? Do you have time to listen to someone? Do you have time of communion? Do you have this time? That's our walk with our Lord Jesus Christ. In that each and every one of us realizing that salvation has no destination. Salvation is a journey with no destination. In that none of us can ever say that I have reached. None of us should ever say that he or she has reached. Because salvation is a journey. It's a journey of discovery. It's a journey of you discovering yourself more and more, realizing, so I could be able to do this, so I could be able to this. The Bible talks about let none of us despise our humble beginning. For me, I'm sure like it's better for you to just start it off. Wherever you shall start it off, you just start it off. That small name, but it shall continue on growing, becoming better and better. And that's the thing that we see in the when they're building the Tower of Babel. First of all, they started off with the bricks, and then later on they were like, why don't we build a tower that reaches up to the heavens so we can make a name for themselves? And so they started off from a particular area, then they thought of bigger things and increasing things. So our identity is very important. And then our Lord, then in the book of Acts, when the disciples appeared and they were being tried, when they appeared, then they were like, these people are untrained. So we are going to look to that verse from the book of Acts chapter 3 verse 14. From the book of Acts 4:13 it says that when they saw the courage of Peter and John and realized they were unschooled, ordinary men, they were astonished. They took note that these men had been with Jesus. It's about time people shall take note that you are with Jesus. It's about time people shall take note that you usually pray in a secret place. In that sometimes I usually hear of testimony of how people were planning the downfall of a believer, but their plan could not prosper. The Bible says that no weapon formed against you shall prosper. It's usually a weapon that fits you. It's like the enemy usually comes up with a weapon that fits you, a weapon that shall bring you down. That's the weapon that the enemy usually tries very much to forge against you. It's a weapon that in that it's carved, it's worked on, in that it's usually the plans of the enemy, the scheme of the enemy. In that, in the book of Psalms, it says that they do not sleep at night. They don't sleep at night as they plan evil. And at the time that I was meditating upon it, I thought of the people who usually break the padlocks, break the security codes, in that they don't sleep at night. They're usually thinking of how they shall break that padlock, they shall break that security code, in that they don't sleep at night because they are planning evil. They're planning evil of how they shall override the system, of how they shall get into the bank, of how they shall get into your property, they shall get into your premises so as to do evil. But for each and every one of us, in that we ought to live a life of being watchful, in that in our inner man, we can only sense when danger is about to happen, when bad things about to happen. We can only sense it in our spirit. So here, in that this man, Peter and John, in that they were like, these guys were unschooled. You see, there's a school of the spirit. And in the school of the spirit is for each and every one of us to allow the Lord to teach us. In that, who knows of the way of the spirit? Lord Jesus Christ was talking to Nicodemus one time round, and then he was telling Nicodemus that the same way as the wind blows, in that you don't know where it comes from, you don't know where it goes. That the same thing of those of whom are born of God. And that for each and every one of us, we are unpredictable. We're unpredictable because it's for each and every one of us, in that we like glide. And like we saw on wings like eagles, just like catching a wave. We get to catch the waves of the spirit. We're able to know of what God is doing now. We ought to live a life of joining God in what He's doing. When we live a life of joining God in what He's doing, then whatever we shall be found doing shall prosper. In that there's usually two types of wave. One is usually man-made wave, and the other one is God wave. In the man-made wave, man trying to come up with a wave, it shall just recline all of a sudden. But in God's types of waves, that each and every one of us as believers, as Christians, we ought to live a life of sensing the move of God, sensing the move of God, sensing the waves of God, so that we can just catch the wave. And then when you catch the wave in your life, now I hope that you are seeing of the picture of someone who uses the skates, uses the boat. I'm forgetting of that name. And that the way he catches, he gets into the boat, then he swims, then when he sees the waves, he gets on his boat, and then he catches the waves, and then from one wave to the other. That is the same thing to change in front of us. Understanding the ways of the spirit, being in the school of the spirit where you know and understand the things about finance, the things about raising up children, the things about raising up your family. You understand everything in that, how it ought to be done, how it ought to be carried out. This is a way that each and every one of us should desire to live this kind of life. So here they were unschooled, ordinary men, in that people will be like, where are you from? my brother has played their music, Mkash and Jerebed, and Mkash and Jerebed one time round went for a contest, and then they were not fully sure of which song they shall. It was a contest of various musicians. They were not aware of which song they shall sing, and then they sang one of their song, and then the adjudicators really loved their song, and then they were recommended to one of the best singer. Someone very known, and then this guy was like, where have you been? And so that's something I want to tell everyone of, in that you ordinary person, doesn't matter how people consider you, doesn't matter how people treat you, doesn't matter how you dress, in that people consider you to be, but we should change our dressing and not how to be addressed. But just there's a time that I was at UoN, University of Nairobi. Then the lecturer was like telling us that, live within your standard. Don't try to live a life that you are not supposed to live. Live within your limit. Live within your standard, so that not to get into depression. You see, sometimes people want to live in a standard standards like everyone else, but you end up hurting yourself. So let us not hurt ourselves. Let us live with the standard that we are able to live in, so that when we grow, we grow. In that, allow yourself to grow. Allow yourself to grow. Allow yourself to grow. So you are seeing here ordinary men. Then my friend Mkash and Jerebed, the person was like, where have you been? Where have you been? Where have you been? So let it be something that each and every one of us shall be found asking him, where have you been? You have been looking for someone with integrity. You have been looking for someone who has knowledge of these things. Where have you been? But for you, God has been waking you up, telling you to tune in. You see, our God is a God who has sense of humor. And that he can wake you up, make you to log into a particular website, so that you can look to a particular program, you can look to a particular machine, you can look to a particular design. In that, God is a God in that he cares about you, he cares about your well-being. And so allow yourself in that you ordinary person, in that you shall amaze men and women. This is why I'm speaking to you. Shalom, shalom, praise the Lord. My name is Charlie G. This is Lesson Today. Happy New Month. It's now the month of July. I don't know how it has been with you, but for me it has been a wonderful time, an interesting season that the Lord has been, that I've been through. In the Bible, in the book of Daniel, say that, and those of whom know their God, they shall grow strong and do exploit. So long as it's today, let us continue on hearing the word of the Lord, continue on encouraging each other. And so since it's a new month, we're going to be doing a new book, and I've already started sharing it. Today we are in chapter 2, we are heading to chapter 3, in that now we are doing the book of 1 Corinthians, in that we are done with the book of Ezra, done with the book of Acts, done with the book of Daniel, done with the book of Leviticus, done with the book of Deuteronomy, done with quite a number of books, and you can find them all in the Slice of Today app. If you have missed them, you can find them all in the Slice of Today app, is what I'm looking at right now, in that we have done the book of Romans, done the book of Deuteronomy, done the book of Romans, done the book of Daniel, Acts, a number of books. So this time around, we're doing the book of 1 Corinthians. And I know that it's going to be a wonderful journey. 1 Corinthians ends with chapter 16. Then later on, we dive into 2 Corinthians. It's going to be really, going to be exciting. And so I don't know if you're following us, follow us in Instagram, follow us in our Instagram is Slice_of_Today, Telegram Slice of Today. WhatsApp, you are my phone number. I'm gonna add it to at the end of this. Yes, Instagram, Twitter is at Slice of Today. YouTube is Slice of Today. What else? Facebook, Slice of Today. So get to join, get to like, get to subscribe, get to share with other friends. Let each and every one of us be part of this. You see, the life of Christian is a life of invitation. Our Lord Jesus Christ invited the disciples to follow him, and he shall make them great men. Just Christ told them, follow me and I'll make you fishers of men. So that seems to each and every one of us. I'm inviting you to like, to subscribe, to follow. Let each and every one of us be inspired. And also, we are having a WordPress blog. It's called Slice of the Day. Slice of the Day, where you shall share the mysteries of God, the revelation that I get to get. And I know that you believe that each and every one of us are going to keep on becoming better versions of ourselves. And I started off the how we live this agenda respective. And I also welcome you to joining it. So we are doing a lot because of God's goodness. The Bible talks about Paul writes and say that I've heard of the word of the Lord has grown and is bearing fruits in our life. And so as God's word continue on growing in our life, and knowing that you will reach any one of us and find bearing fruits. Bearing fruits, they say that bear fruits what of your repentance, bear fruits of the repair. I saw it's a call of fruitfulness to each and every one of us. I saw that God has been good to me. I also pray the same grace that He shall also be good to you. Expand your territory in that whatever your heart desire is, whatever your dreams are, just chase after them, and you shall achieve them for God's glory and honor. And so in this new month of June, of July, I'm doing that my identity. Who I am, who am I, who am I? I am who I am because the I am tells me who I am. I am who I am because the I am tells me who I am. I am. And then I also started off Celestial Today's on the weekends doing Sing Today. It's a wonderful edition. Lately we had Daisy and Vian. And I know that we believe for the forthcoming Saturdays we shall have other minister come and minister to each and every one of us. So shalom till next time. May God bless you and keep you. Yeah. And then they were astonished. And they took note. It's about time that people shall take note in our generation. Let people take note of the songs that you sing. Songs bathed in the spirit. People shall be found taking note of them and recognize there's something different about your music. There's something different about your design. There's something different about your art. There's something different about your speech. There's something different about your presentation. There's something different. This different is Jesus Christ, is the Spirit of God. In that you see, as in Apostle Solomon shall say that if everything was freely given, what could have been the reward of obedience? If everything was freely given, what could have been the reward of obedience? So trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in here but to trust and obey. In that, yes, each and every one of us, the children of God, but the way you live that life of a child of God, but the way you come to the full realization of who you are in Him, in that that's usually the difference maker. In that you can be a company, everyone is saying that they are born again, but for usually pray, usually fast, in that for you things will be different. For you this will be different. You'll be honored before them. Then you'll be like, they'll be like telling God it's unfair, but God is like you. You haven't worked with your anger. You haven't worked with your pride. You haven't worked in that God doesn't want to achieve Him. In that God, the Bible says that for He leads us in path of righteousness for His name's sake. Whose name? His name's sake. He leads us in path of righteousness for His name's sake. And so it's a thing for us allowing God to lead us, allowing God to direct us, allowing God to order our steps. The Bible says that for the steps of the righteous are ordered by the Lord, in that you come into the realization of knowing that you have already been made righteous. So lately I've talked of two things, in that righteousness, place of prayer. And so today is our walk with God, our walk with the Lord Jesus Christ. It's a beautiful walk. And then they took note that this man had been with Jesus. It's about time people shall get to know of the different that our Lord Jesus Christ gets to do. In that, just the other day, I was evangelizing to another guy. Then he told me that he's driving, and he's a young guy driving. And then I told him about now in your vehicle playing gospel song, the people will be like, "Wow, you're born again." Yes, it's for each and every one of us. Use whatever you are having. Use whatever you are having to draw people to God, to make people desire the things of God for God's glory and honor. And so we're gonna look to one verse. We're gonna look at a verse that speaks of a very important thing. I no longer call you servant, but I call you friends. I no longer call you servant, but I call you friends. Why? Because of the way he had walked, because of the way the disciples had walked with our Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ now tells them, I no longer call you servant, but I call you my friends. Isn't that a beautiful thing? In that you're coming to become you're being entrusted with secrets of God's kingdom. Sorry, I'm taking long. It's an easy one. John chapter 15, verse 15. John 15, 15. It says, on the book of John chapter 15, verse 15, say that, I no longer call you servant. Our Lord Jesus Christ is speaking, so let us listen. I no longer call you servant, because a servant does not know his master's business. Instead, I have called you friends, for everything that I learned from my father, I have made known to you. You see, as in, sometimes people usually like, we cannot dismiss Jesus Christ. We cannot put aside our Lord Jesus Christ. Why? Because God loves Jesus. People may live a life of saying that they are good with God. What about Jesus? If you don't accept Jesus Christ, if you deny Jesus Christ, then you already stand condemned. And so in the book of John, chapter 15, verse 15, Jesus Christ said that, I no longer call you servants. No longer do I call you servant, for a servant does not know what his master is doing. And so it's an invitation to each and every one of us, because of our walk with the Lord Jesus Christ, our daily walk with the Lord Jesus Christ. Our Lord Jesus Christ said that if anyone is to follow me, let him deny himself, carry his cross, and follow me daily. It's a thing of daily life. It's a thing of daily living. In that when you get that promotion, you get that business, in that don't put aside your devotion to God. Don't put aside you reading the Bible, you praying, in that don't put it aside. It's a work. Sometimes people usually neglect their devotion. People usually neglect their time with God. But I'm speaking to each and every one of us. It's a devotion. It's a lifestyle that each and every one of us should have. That each and every one of us should live a lifestyle. No longer do I call you servant, for a servant does not know his master, what his master is doing. Don't you like that invitation, in that you know of the moves of God, you know of the ways of God, you're knowing of the thoughts of God. The Bible says that for God's thoughts ain't like our thoughts, neither is ways like our way. As high as the heaven is above the earth, so far as is way far beyond our ways, and it's not far beyond our thoughts. But God is inviting each and every one of us in that higher, in that let us now have the mind of Christ. Let us now have the mind of Christ, knowing that I am righteous, I have been redeemed, I have been restored. I am God's son, I am God's daughter. In that, having that kind of mind, in that it's a mind that ain't of the world. But I have called you friends, for all things that I've heard from my Father, I have made known to you. And so our Lord Jesus Christ, in the Bible say that in the old time, God used to speak to his people through the prophets. But in our dispensation of grace, in this time that you're living in, God is speaking to us through his Son, Jesus Christ. And so if you're to hear what God is saying, if you're to see what God is doing, and that we need our Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ was telling them that I have, for all things that I have heard from my Father, I have made known to you. You did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you so that you should go and bear fruit, that your fruit should remain, and whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you. And so he's a God who chose each and every one of us. And so since you have been chosen, let each and every one of us allow ourselves to walk with God, allow ourselves to fellowship with him, allow ourselves to be built up. And so your walk with God is very important. Doesn't matter how people of the world shall consider you. When Noah was working on the ark, in that as he was hammering it, as he was sowing, hammering the nails through the wood, and then measuring everything, people of the world, they'll continue on with their worldly life in sin, in adultery, in marriage, in all those things. But the day that the flood came, they understood that Noah was doing a noble thing. And that's why Paul writes and says that work out your salvation in fear and trembling. People don't understand why you go for Kesha and yet you still have the position, and yet you still have the top ranking, and yet you have been awarded the best person, the person who has worked the best in the company. People don't understand why you still have to go for Kesha, why you still have to read the Bible, why you still have to call your pastor, why you still have to give your tithing, why you still have to give your offering. People do not understand. But when they see you being promoted, when they see you still continue on soaring high, they'll be like, I need to know your God. I need to meet your God. And so let it be a word for each and every one of us, in that let us live a life of walking with our Lord Jesus Christ. Don't neglect your walk with him, in that you're becoming more. People will take note that you have been with Jesus. Shalom, shalom. Till next time, may the Lord bless you and keep you.